So today we're looking at a brand new gaming laptop, the ASUS ROG Zephyrus S GX701. Outside of the obviously very confusing name, this is not just your ordinary gaming laptop. This is the first laptop that we're getting to check out ourselves that has these new RTX mobile graphics inside. So let's see if this laptop can push gaming laptops to a whole new level in terms of performance. So on the surface, this just looks like a pretty standard 17-inch gaming laptop. But when you open it, you see just how different this is from pretty much any other laptop you've ever used, especially if you haven't seen this design before. Essentially, the keyboard and the touchpad have been moved all the way down to the bottom of the keyboard deck, leaving this big open space that we like to call the awkward Zephyrus forehead. And it doesn't have anything in it. It doesn't have a speaker in it or anything. It's just a spot for air to pass through. And just right off the bat, looking at this design and actually using it, there's some pretty obvious reasons why this isn't a great design. In fact, I've got five. So number one, it's terrible for left-handers. So good luck, lefties. Number two, because the touchpad and the keyboard sit side by side, the keyboard layout is kind of cramped, especially with these tiny little arrow keys down here. Number three, it's uncomfortable to use for long periods of time because there's nowhere to put your wrists. Number four, you can't really use it on your lap as a laptop without looking like an idiot. And number five, it doesn't have a true number pad, which on a 17-inch gaming laptop, you kind of would actually want and it would actually use. The little digital number pad that you get here really just doesn't replace that. So in what world does this design actually make sense? Well, it makes sense if you're trying to cool some really powerful components and squeeze it into a very thin and light chassis. And that's exactly what the Zephyrus S is doing. It has an RTX 2080 Max-Q graphics card on the inside, and it also has a 6-core overclockable Intel processor. So very hot, very powerful components. And this thing is pretty thin and light. To keep things thin while you're actually carrying this laptop around, ASUS included a little pop-out vent beneath the laptop that, again, gives additional airflow for the cooling of these components. The secondary function of this design is to keep your hands away from those hot surfaces. It's pretty ingenious the way this works, actually, and it's an issue that's solved on this laptop that pretty much every other gaming laptop has to deal with. So with improved thermals, you can expect improved game performance, and on the Zephyrus S, that is totally true. This is an awesome laptop to game on. The 17-inch screen checks all the boxes for gaming. It's 1080p matte, has a 144Hz high refresh panel, and it supports G-Sync. It even has decent color accuracy and contrast. The best part is that the RTX GPU inside can actually support this super fast display. It's no sweat getting over 100 frames per second in games like Fortnite and Battlefield 5 on Ultra. And man, the combination of that high refresh and support for G-Sync make for some really amazing, smooth gameplay. Even in Civilization 6, we were getting over 60 frames per second, while tougher games like Assassin's Creed Odyssey or Deus Ex were still totally playable at max settings, just not up to 60 frames per second. I don't want to downplay this because it is pretty mind-blowing that you can get this kind of performance in a laptop, let alone a laptop this thin and light. This isn't the thinnest gaming laptop we're seeing coming out this year. That probably goes to the MSI GS75, which is another 17-inch laptop. But what the Zephyrus S does is put performance that we typically would have only seen in really thick gaming laptops like the Alienware 17 or one of the Predator laptops. It takes that and actually recreates it in a laptop that is really thin and light, and that's really impressive. So it's a performer. It's a really great gaming machine, but that's not the end of the story. There's a few other weird things that we just have to point out about it. The first thing that's missing here is a webcam. It doesn't have one at all. They've trimmed the bezels around the display, which is, again, really nice. And we're seeing that in pretty much any laptop that you can buy in 2019. But rather than trying to squeeze it into the top or maybe even at the bottom, this one just doesn't have one. They just removed it completely and said, you're gonna have to buy an external camera if you wanna use one. Which I guess that's fine for people who wanna use this primarily just as a gaming laptop. But for everyone else that might need one once in a while, that's kind of annoying. Another thing that's missing has to do with the ports. You have kind of the things you'd expect, like HDMI, USB-A, USB-C, but what's missing is an Ethernet jack, which is something a lot of gamers are looking for. So you can hardwire without having to use a dongle. And then it also doesn't have Thunderbolt 3 support, which was kind of surprising to see on a premium gaming laptop like this. And another thing this is missing is any kind of Windows Hello support. It's not doesn't come standard in gaming laptops a lot of times, but I really wish we could have seen a fingerprint reader. Again, we don't have a webcam at all, so you can't have a facial recognition thing for Windows Hello, but you got nothing at all here, so you're gonna have to rely on passwords and pins. So there's a lot of things missing here, but I gotta mention one other thing, and that's the battery life. So this is a G-Sync laptop, meaning it gets horrible battery life, and that's kind of what we'd expect. We're talking like hour, hour and a half for basic web browsing or video. It's really bad. What Asus does on this laptop, though, apparently, is bring support for both G-Sync and Optimus, which usually you can only have one or the other. You know, one will get you that tear-free gaming experience, and the other will give you better battery life. And on this laptop, apparently, you can switch between these two fairly easily. So we're hoping that this Optimus mode should give you at least a couple extra hours of battery life, which still honestly isn't great, but it'll at least bring it up to the point where it can actually be unplugged and used for a little bit. So is this very expensive gaming laptop worth the money? Should it be your next gaming laptop purchase? And the answer is maybe. I mean, it's a really, really good gaming laptop. I mean, it has room for expansion, and you can put extra storage and extra RAM in it. You can go up to 24 gigabytes. And the graphics performance here is just really impressive, and the way the thermal system works is really impressive. So if you're looking for something that's just a gaming laptop, this actually does it really well. The problem for me is just the whole experience of the product in general. It doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Asus has gone through all this work to squeeze all this performance into a really thin and light chassis, but I can't put this thing in my backpack. I mean, it's 17 inches. I mean, I can't bring this to a coffee shop. It has no battery life. I can't bring it to work. It looks like this, you know? And like, if I spend a lot of time typing on this, I'm gonna get a wrist strain. So I think there are some problems with this design and the whole idea of this product, because I think for most people, you're gonna want something that's a little bit sleeker, that works as a gaming laptop and as a normal laptop in your normal day life, or you want something that's just straight up power, and there are some great options for that as well, and it doesn't have these same concessions and compromises that this thing does. So depending on what you're looking for in a gaming laptop, I think you're gonna find a better option in one of those two camps that fits more what you're looking for and is honestly a better value for what you're getting. Hey, thanks for checking out this review. Let us know in the comments what you think of the Zephyrus S. Do you think you could actually get comfortable with this design over time? And what gaming laptop are you most excited to check out in this year? There's a ton of them coming out. So let us know what you're most excited for in the comments. And if you want to read our full written review, it goes into all the details. Check it out at digitaltrends.com and hit subscribe if you want to see more videos from us.